हाय नमस्ते, माय नेम इज़ सोमनाथ पाल एंड वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल आई एम फेनेलुम्बू। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न हाउ टू जर्मिनेट विक्टोरिया सीड्स। नाउ व्हाट इज़ विक्टोरिया? देर आर विक्टोरिया इज़ अ सब स्पीसीज, इट कम्स इन अ फैमिली ट्री ऑफ नेम्फेसिस। सो विक्टोरिया इज़ बेसिकली वाटर लिली। नाउ विक्टोरियाज आर वेरी ह्यूज प्लांट। There are two species mostly found in Victoria. One is Victoria amazonica, the other is Victoria crucina. Victoria amazonica, each leaf of Victoria amazonica can be up to 9 feet in diameter. So you can guess, if the plant has 5 leaves, just multiply 9 to 5. So it is almost like 45 to 50 feet each plant. And the leaves of the Victoria amazonica is more on the dark maroonish type, reddish, dark reddish maroon type. So the underneath of leaves and the even the upward, so it is more reddish tone. And the rim, the upward rim is lesser compared to crucina. So Victoria amazonica is a more bigger, huge plant. So each leaf can be 9 feet in diameter and the upward rim will be less and the plant will be overall more reddish, very reddish. And one more, the first day flower will be, it is a night blooming plant, so the first night flower will be white, pure white, and the second day it will be dark pink to maroonish, so somewhere between pink to maroonish, it depends upon your water temperature. And crucina on the other hand, it will be a smaller plant, more compact plant with more upward rim. So the rim, the leaf rim will be more upward. And the each leaf size will be around 6 feet in diameter when the plant is to the maturity, in the very mature. So that is the size of the each leaf. So if it has 5 leaves, just multiply, it will be around 25 to 30 feet with a, yeah. And this is also a night blooming water lily. So the first day flower will be white and the second day flower will be soft pink, soft baby pink. So the difference between crucina and amazonica is mostly three. The leaves, crucina has very greenish leaves, it is very green leaves, and amazonica has reddish leaves. Second is crucina has more upward rim, so the leaf rims will be more upward, and amazonica has less upward rim. Third is the leaf size. Amazonica leaves gets very huge, it becomes around 9 feet in diameter in maturity. That's the most largest leaf size we have found as of now. And crucina, on the other hand, has a leaf size of around 6 feet in maturity. That's the most we have found. And the fourth difference is crucina secondary flower is soft pink, while Victoria amazonica secondary flower will be pink, between pink to maroon. So it could be pink, dark pink, and it could also be maroon, pinkish maroon. So these are the four major differences. Now if we go on the seeds, how to germinate the seeds, these are considered as annuals in place where there is very cold. So once they die, since they do not make any tuber, Victoria amazonica, Victoria crucina, and any of the hybrids from these two crosses never make any kind of bulbs or their tubers. So the only way to grow them, propagate them, is through seeds. So it's very necessary to understand how to germinate the seeds and how they grow. So in cold places they are considered as annual, but places like us in India, tropical places where the temperature is not very cold, they can be considered as perennial, and they can live up to many years, maybe 4 years, 5 years, if you take a proper care, in your light winter period, it can thrive many years. So these are the few differences between amazonica and Victoria. And many water gardens keep these plants, huge plants, massive plants, because these are the center of attractions. They become very big, very huge, and you don't need to have many plants. Just one water lily is enough to get all the attention. So one plant with 50 feet in spread, if you have two such plants, you will have two big water bodies you can have. So now the seeds of the Amazonica and Cruziana are pea size, very smaller. I show you the seeds. This is the seeds. This seeds is pea size seeds, a little smaller than the pea size of this pea size seeds. So this, the seeds of Victoria Amazonica and Cruziana both has to remain in water or has to remain wet all the time. If you keep them in dry, if you dry them, the viability of the seeds will be lost, the seeds will be dead, it won't come. So to have the viability in the seeds, you need to keep them moist, you need to keep them wet or in water all the time. Second is fresh seeds, freshly collected seeds has more viability. The more you keep them, the more you store them, the more they lose their viability. So if you have a Victoria Amazonica seeds from last 4 years, 3 years you have stored, so they may not have the viability, or very few seeds may germinate and the vigor of the seeds may not be up to the mark. So the seeds will be very slow to grow, very slow to respond, and very kind of have issues and may not survive. They may not have the hardiness. So this is the one thing. The seeds needs to be freshly harvested and you need to be planted. And the seeds always need to be kept in water or in. Third is the seeds. If you keep the seeds in a normal temperature, which is for Cruziana, anything above 16 degree to 25 to 28 degree, 30 degree, it will sprout. For Amazonica, between 24 to 30, 32, the seed should sprout. Okay, so one way of doing it to start the seed, it's to have an aquarium setup with heater. The other is if you want to start in your summer period, like in India, the summer is very long. So maybe from Feb and or from the early March up to October, there is a long period of growing the water lilies. So you have a long period. So the seeds is an embryo and a food storage for the plants to grow for a few days. And it has one operculum. I show you the operculum. Here you can see. Just hold for a moment. Here is the operculum. If I hope you've seen it. This is the operculum. This operculum. This video is very necessary for everyone to understand and see. The operculum is a small circle, and in between that circle there is a small dot. It's very small, it's very hard to notice. I try to show you another seeds. This is, see the operculum. Okay, so one is the seeds has two end. This end is more rounder, more broader. The other sides where the operculum is more narrower and more oval than round. So this is where the operculum is. And to increase the germination percentage, we need to nick that operculum. Just below the operculum, there is an embryo. So we need to be very sensitive. We need to be very careful. We do not nick anything other than the operculum. Anything beyond the operculum will hurt the embryo and it will eventually kill the seeds. So the seeds may not come in. So it's very necessary to understand. It's not like a lotus seeds from that if you scrape from anywhere, the water will go inside and the seeds will start to sprout. It's not like that. So you need to sprout. You need to nick the operculum. Just you need to nick the operculum. And no other way, if you nick it or if you scrap it, it will not come. So you need to understand. Just below the operculum, there is an embryo and this. So we will learn here how to nick that operculum very carefully. So we need a pin. We need a safety pin or a stitching pin or any kind of pin with a very sharp needle, like needle also will do. And so just a pin or just some sharp things. You can use the corner, the edge of a knife also if you are very smart enough, if you are good. So we will see now. We are using here the safety pin, this pin. With this we can start to use. Now this is an operculum, this is a pin. I can try to nick like this, but I will suggest you, if you try to nick the operculum like this in this position where the pin goes on the downside, if a little push, a little strength from you can put this pin inside the embryo. So beside this, instead of doing this, I would suggest you to do keep this in line with the seeds. So, and the corner of the pin should be on the upper side, and try to just nick, and when the strength is a little more, just try to put the pin on the upside, so that you do not go to the embryo. Even if you have a little more strength, if you use a little more strength, your hand should go on the upper side. So you just nick the, either you nick the upper operculum or else you don't nick. So you can try again. So you have good chance of doing this. So I know how to handle this pin. We had nicked a little, but I guess I wish to do it a little more. I feel it's not enough. One more thing to notice, the seed's color could vary a little. It could be from a soft green, greenish to brownish. So this seeds is freshly harvested. It has been sent by a friend. And these seeds look like a green color. But there are other seeds which I have from the previous lot which is more brownish. So the color doesn't matter as much the seeds is mature, and the color may vary a little bit. So we have nicked one seeds. The same we need to start do with the other seeds. So I will try to nick one more seed so that you again see. This is the operculum. There's a small circle with in center of this there's a dot. So I will try to nick just the operculum without hurting the embryo, and I will keep this pin like this. This isn't one shot. Some seeds are very easy to nick. You just put your needles inside and just give a little push, it will come out, the operculum will come out. But with some seeds it's difficult. So with some seeds you need to have a lot of effort, you need to put more efforts. You see the operculum has been nicked now. There is a small white inside, you can see, and then this is enough for the seeds to sprout. Now what happens after this is, from few days to few weeks, maybe 2 weeks or one to two weeks, the seeds will start to sprout. Depend, you keep these seeds after you nick this operculum, you need to keep these seeds in warm water, maybe in a temperature around 24 to 32 should be very ideal for the seeds to sprout. So this is the most important part when you want to germinate the Victoria Amazonica seeds. You need to nick them, and you need to have this, the water temperature should be between 24 to 32 degree. So I have a water aquarium with a heater, so I use that place, that this setup to germinate these seeds. or else what will happen is if the temperature is very cold and if you nick the seeds, it will eventually rot. So instead of rot, it will stay just like this, it will not sprout. So I would rather prefer that you need a temperature between 24 to 32 degree. One more thing, Victoria Amazonica shows good germination when you nick the operculum. It's not necessary that only if you nick the operculum the seed should sprout. Even in a good temperature without nicking the operculum, the seed should sprout on its own. But the germination percentage greatly increase when you nick the operculum. So the nicking of operculum is very crucial when it comes to Victoria Amazonica. But when we talk about Cruziana, the nicking of operculum does not show any relevance with the germination. So the germination percentage does not change with Cruziana even if you nick or even if you don't nick. And as I feel in my with my previous experience, Cruziana seeds are very difficult to nick. It's not very easy like the way Amazonica been nicked, they can easily come out the operculum. With Cruziana, it's not very easy. It's very difficult to nick the operculum. And even after you nick the operculum, the seeds may not show greater amount of germination. It will germinate on its own, on its the way it wants. This one thing. Now what happens is after a few days, the seeds start to sprout. You can see the white tip like a fungus surrounded towards the operculum gradually for first two, three days. It will, you will see a whitish kind of encircle surrounded towards an operculum. Gradually you will see a white something coming out, and then you see first filiform leaves. I show you how the leaves looks like. So we have two Victoria Amazonica seeds sprouted. I have four. So here these seeds have sprouted, and this is almost about 2.5 weeks now. So this has been nicked almost around 16-17 days now, 2.5 weeks. So this seeds has this first, this is being called as first filiform leaves. This is the first leaf which have been formed. After this, first haested leaf has been came. This is the haested leaf. Now the third haested leaf will come from here. So this will be the third haested leaf. Filiform leaf, first it makes the filiform leaves, then the first haested leaf, then third, second haested leaf. And while it has the first haested leaves, it also start to make roots. Now you see, this seeds has the roots. This is the roots. And if I guess the clarity is not so good, but in case if you can see these seeds, the roots are slightly pinkish. I guess if it has to be something with the genes of the plant, and this is more kind of a burgundy or reddish kind of an total. You can see the plant, it is more reddish, and as it matures it will have more reddish leaves. First it will make triangular leaves. First floating leaf will be more triangular, and gradually after fifth leaf, the leaves will become more in circle, more round. So you need to wait almost for a month. The leaf, each floating leaf can take almost around three weeks to almost a month to have the first floating leaf. And from that first floating leaf to the fourth floating leaves, each leaf can take almost 1 week period time depending upon the growth. And gradually this period should be very less. It will be 6 days in one leaf, it will take 6 days, the other leaf will take 5 days. It will come like this, and it will start to be much bigger. Now what we do is we also show you how to plant this. Now since Victoria becomes very huge plant, massive plant, and it needs a very large space to grow, it also needs a very big inner pot. So as of now, we don't feel that it's very feasible for us to take a very huge plant. Why so is, many of the seedling may not turn into a very mature plants. Many of them will have a more mortality, they will die in between and they will not come up. So it's not feasible. We want to start with the smaller pot. As the plant grows up, we will change the pot and we will try to shift them in different pots as per their growth. So now this plant is very small. It doesn't need much of nutrition. It doesn't need much of space. We can start with a smaller space, and as it is grows very big, we can shift them in a bigger pot, bigger inner pot, bigger outer pot, and then gradually, maybe after 2 months from now, or maybe after 1.5 months from now, 2 months for Victoria Amazonica, I believe, it's slow. We can shape them in a pond, in a 20-foot pond, in a 30-foot pond should do too. The plant will be the smallest pot used for this, which recorded to have a flower, was a 4-inch pot with a 4-inch inner pot. It has given few buds, and the largest could be anything you can plant directly in your pond. If you have a very big pond, you can even plant them directly in the soil, and it can become very massive. So it's the minimum which has been recorded was 4-inch pot, inner pot used for Victoria Amazonica to flower, and the maximum could be anything. So your pot will depend, your inner pot will, and your outer pot will depend how much your plant is, how big your plant is going to be. So it's always remember that how big pot you take, how big your outer or inner pot you take, will define that how bigger this Victoria is going to be. Sorry, I'm not moving around, I'm just sitting and doing everything from here. So we have this pot, this is almost a 3-inch pot, you can see, and I had put this, I am using clay soil, so I will use clay soil again for this too. And what I will do, I will just use my finger, my index finger, and put a hole here, and I will put the seeds in this, and then I softly cover the seeds with the soil without hurting the roots, without disturbing the plants, and nothing. It's done. And now I will place this in water. Initially, I will keep the water level very low, maybe around 7 inches, 8 inches should do. So maybe this is the pot, and maybe above this, 7 inch, 8 inch should do. And then maybe as soon the plant grows big, huge, I will change the inner pot as well as the outer pot. Hope this much is enough for you, for you to start, and encourage you to grow Victoria. I hope after this video, many will start to grow Victoria, and you will be fascinated if you see how big this becomes, how beautiful it is. We will also share some of the videos, some of the pictures of the previously grown Victoria with us. We have not able to grow it very big since we do not have a large space with us before, but we wish to grow them this year. So I hope we will be able to succeed to get them in a good size and to get beautiful flowers. This much for this week now. Hope you have liked this video. Please do share this video with other water gardening enthusiasts who wish to grow Victoria and they need some help. Maybe other gardening groups, they may be quite fascinated to know and learn about Victoria and how beautiful this plant is. And do share your comments, your suggestions to us. We will try to be improved in every way possible. This much for now. I say goodbye. Thank you. Bye.